Teddy Rubskin here, and with the Star Wars Force Awakens coming out real fucking soon, I think it's important that we talk about the Star Wars prequels, right? Yeah, because we talked about the original Star Wars trilogy, Star Wars, Empire Strikes Back, Return of the Jedi. Well, now we gotta talk about the prequel series, with the Phantom Menace, Attack of the Clones, and Revenge of the Sith. Yeah. But before we talk about that, we gotta go back. We gotta go back to the 90s, to the world before Star Wars made its fucking glorious comeback. And really, it really all starts with the toys. In 1995, George Lucas went back to Kenner to start putting out Star Wars toys again. You know? And Kenner was actually more than happy to start making Star Wars toys again. Yeah. They loved that license, and they put out fucking... The first line included Luke Skywalker, Han Solo, Chewbacca, you know, Darth Vader, the whole original crew, right? They all had a new look and shit like that. But yeah, Star Wars toys were on the market for the first time in fucking years, and they automatically started selling. So that's how he got the fucking studio interested in Star Wars. But originally, in 97... he did a special edition version of the original films, right? Putting out Star Wars, Empire Strikes Back, and Return of the Jedi in new, fully digitally enhanced, and, you know, throwing in some, you know, missing footage and shit, and yeah, the special editions, which, yeah, it was also kind of a test for the next level, which would be a whole new fucking Star Wars movie, right? So a lot of the effects they did in the special edition that they added to the film were more or less tests for what they were going to do with the first fully original Star Wars in fucking years. But it should have been a warning sign, right? Because Jabba the Hutt, yeah, sequencing Star Wars with Jabba the Hutt and Han Solo looked terrible. It really did. And that should have been a warning sign. But no, we didn't heed the warnings, right? You know, in 1999, everybody got really fucking excited and rushed out to see the first major movie that was, you know, built on the excitement of fucking Star Wars. I'm talking about Wing Commander. Yeah, everybody rushed out to see Wing Commander because there was actually a trailer for Star Wars The Phantom Menace before it, right? Yeah, people went to see Wing Commander just to see the trailer for Star Wars Phantom Menace. Because fuck that movie. Wing Commander, fuck that fucking film. It's fucking terrible.
Wish me luck.
Gear up.
Battle stations.
Lock on.
Yeah!
And strike back.
That's not bad.
You know, a fucking movie based on a video game. A video game which, by the way, starred Mark Hamill and Malcolm McDowell and was widely known as a fucking really awesome video game. But no, when they made a movie, they're like, fuck Mark Hamill. Who wants to see him in a fucking movie? No, we got fucking Freddie Prinze Jr. and Matthew Lillard. Yeah. Oh, yeah, everybody wants to see them, right? Fuck no. The only people that went to see that movie in the theaters were people who wanted to see the trailer for Star Wars Episode 1, right? Because in the days before YouTube, you wanted to see a movie trailer, you had to go to the movies and just hope that that trailer was playing in front of the movie you went to fucking see. You know what I'm saying? It's back in those days, movies were packaged with particular movies as their trailer, you know.
That's not bad.
From 20th Century Fox.
Get out!
I really don't like this guy at all, man.
Yeah, I mean, seriously. People were paying the ticket to go see Wing Commander, watching the fucking trailer for Episode 1, and then leaving the fucking theater. Like, fuck, they didn't give a shit about Wing Commander. They just wanted to see the trailer for the new fucking Star Wars movie. Episode 1, man. This is the beginning. Oh my god. So excited. Right? And they were already buying the fucking toys for The Phantom Menace before the movie even came out. You know? Just like today. When everybody's already buying the toys for Force Awakens. We don't even know what it is yet. You know? People are buying the fucking Kylo Ren action figure. With no idea who the fuck this Kylo Ren guy even is. You know? But just like back in the day. In 99. People were buying fucking Darth Maul, without even seeing him in the movie yet. Everybody knew his name, too. He's Darth Maul. He's got the double-edged lightsaber. Like, yeah. I mean, nobody knew who the rest of these guys are. Who's this Jesus-looking guy? We don't know, but we were buying the fucking toys. Who's this chick right here? Oh, it's the queen. Queen something or other. She's probably the mom from fucking Princess Leia. That makes sense, you know? The queen is the mom of the fucking princess, right? Yeah. Well, we didn't know what it was about, but we were buying the fucking toys anyway, you know? Yeah. But same like today. Well, we're buying the fucking toys to Star Wars Force Awakens. We don't know who the fuck this guy is. You know? Who is this guy? Who's this fucking chick? You know? We don't know. She's probably like, I don't know. People are saying maybe she's Han Solo's daughter. Maybe she's Luke Skywalker's daughter. You know? We don't know. We don't know who the fuck this chick is. Maybe she's nobody's daughter. Maybe she's just some chick. Although she's probably Luke Skywalker's daughter. I mean, think about it. Probably Luke Skywalker's daughter. Not Han and Leia, but... Wait. We were talking about The Phantom Menace, right? And when that movie premiered, oh my God, there were people camping out, right? Waiting for that fucking film. The premiere of that movie was like Black Friday. It was insane. Right? There were lines all over the place, people trampling each other to fucking see it. It's crazy. And it was a huge fucking success. It made a shitload of fucking money. Oh my God. But some people would like to say that at first people were very happy with it and that the complaints came up later. But no. People were pissed off at Phantom Menace right away about two very, very big fucking things. Number one, of course, is Jar Jar Binks. Everybody fucking hated Jar Jar Binks right a fucking way because he's fucking obnoxious. He's annoying as shit, you know, and he's in the movie the whole fucking time. We don't get a break from fucking Jar Jar Binks. He's there the whole time. I mean, every fucking scene. Oh my God, it just got old. It was easy to tell that people hated Jar Jar Binks because his toys didn't sell and people were bitching about it. I mean, these are the days before the internet was a big thing. But the hatred of fucking Jar Jar Binks was loud. You could fucking hear it for miles. And man, those store shelves were sure as shit full of fucking Jar Jar toys that nobody fucking wanted.
He's embarrassing.
But number two is even bigger than Jar Jar Binks. I mean, it's bigger because it has an even more impact on the whole fucking Star Wars universe. You know, number two is the goddamn MIDI motherfucking chlorians. Or whatever the fuck these tiny little microscopic organisms that float around in your fucking Jedi blood and nobody else's, right? These microscopic organisms that are the source of the Force? What? The source of the Force? I thought the Force was some kind of, supernatural force that was just, it was just everywhere, you know, like gravity. It was between the rocks and the trees, it was just everywhere. That's some fucking measurable, tangible thing that's in your fucking blood. It's in some people's blood, but it's not in everybody's blood.
What are midichlorians?
Midichlorians are a microscopic life form that resides within all living cells.
They live inside me.
Inside your cells, yeah.
No, that's fucking bullshit. And the fans responded right away because they didn't like it. They wanted the Force to be some mystical thing, not some biological bullshit. You know, and that is one of the things that was actually completely removed from the rest of the fucking Star Wars prequel movies, you know. Yeah. There was less of Jar Jar Binks in Attack of the Clones and Revenge of the Sith, but he still got a fucking cameo, right? He was still there, like, in the background. But the MIDI motherfucking chlorians were completely squeegeeing out of all of fucking Star Wars, you know, not mentioned again. Not mentioned at all, you know. But we don't know where it was going to go, you know, since it was removed, you know, since George Lucas changed the story, which he can do because he was making it up as he went along, you know. I don't like this bullshit where people actually think that George Lucas actually had the whole fucking story in his head since the fucking 70s. No, he didn't, you know. People think he had, like, this whole 12-part epic written, like, back in the day. Like, no. If you go back to the original script for Star Wars, it's actually called The Adventures of Luke Starkiller, Episode 1, The Star Wars, right? That's what it's fucking called, you know? It originally was supposed to be called The Adventures of Luke Starkiller, right? Because his name was Starkiller before they changed it to Skywalker, right? And George Lucas was passing the script around Hollywood, showing people, and people were like, what the fuck is this? Some kind of space adventure? This is crazy. It wasn't until later when he started showing people the script along with Ralph McQuarrie fucking artwork, right? These wonderful pieces of art done by Ralph McQuarrie, you know, he did this concept art that showed, basically fleshed out the Star Wars world, you know, giving you an idea of what it was going to look like. That's when people started getting excited about the Star Wars movie. That's when the studios started saying, maybe this will make a good movie, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. But originally, the first movie was Episode 1. It was all about Luke Starkiller, you know? Yeah, because George Lucas fucking changed it. He was willing to fucking change it at any given time, you know? That's what happened with the prequels. He fucking changed it. He was like, okay, people don't like the way the Phantom Menace is going, so he changed some shit. He fucking tossed Jar Jar Binks out. He decided not to mention the midichlorians anymore. You know, who knows what else was changed? There was a lot of stuff mentioned in the first movie about some kind of prophecy and how Anakin was special. He had some special powers, but that's not really mentioned ever again. And people didn't like Attack of the Clones much either. People hated Attack of the Clones. So, Revenge of the Sith, once again, it was changed. It went a lot fucking darker, you know?
Do it.
In fact, I think they fucked up from the very fucking beginning, you know? With the events of Revenge of the Sith. Should have happened in, like, Episode 2. You know, get on it. Get on it. Turn fucking Anakin into Darth Vader sooner. You know? Hell, fuck, we don't even need the fucking first movie. Skip it. I don't want to see fucking Anakin as a little fucking kid. That's fucking pointless. How about if the entire fucking prequel series was all about, you know, Obi-Wan training Anakin? That would have been great, because training montages are awesome. You know? I love fucking Bloodsport with the fucking training montages. You know, training is interesting. Fucking Karate Kid movies and shit. I'd like to see some fucking Jedi training. What do you gotta actually do to be a fucking Jedi, you know? It's one of the reasons I like Empire Strikes Back, because Yoda is training Luke Skywalker. It's fucking cool. It's interesting. You learn shit, you know? But the prequels would have been better if it was more about fucking Obi-Wan training Anakin. But we really don't see any of that in the fucking Star Wars prequels. We don't. Never fucking see, you know, Obi-Wan training Anakin at all. Why not? You know, I want to see more of Obi-Wan training Anakin, you know? I want to know what the Jedi training involves, you know? I mean, in the first movie, Obi-Wan is talking about how, I guess he didn't train Anakin well enough. He ended up turning to the dark side. Well, I want to know what kind of mistakes he made in the training. What did he do wrong? You know? I mean, in Empire Strikes Back, Yoda says that Luke is too old to begin the training, right? Which, you know, I guess that makes sense because Luke's like full grown at that time. But then in Phantom Menace, Yoda says that Anakin is too old to begin the training. But wait, he's like a little kid. How young do you have to be to begin the fucking Jedi training? You know, you have to be like a baby? I mean, because in another part we see where Yoda's like training a class of little Jedis, and they're like little baby Jedis, they're little kids, right? Well, I want to see more of that. I want to know what the Jedi training involves, you know? You have to like run obstacle courses, you have to do like lightsaber shit. I want to know. That's the interesting part there. You know, and they didn't fucking do anything with it, you know? We don't get to see any of Anakin's fucking Jedi training. That's fucking stupid. See, I want to see more of Anakin Skywalker's, like, arc, you know, where he slowly turns to the dark side, because it seems like he turned pretty quickly, you know. I mean, he just went from a relatively nice Jedi guy, who maybe might be a little too obsessed with his power level.
My powers have doubled since the last time we met, Count.
All right, Anakin, I know. Your power level's increased, you're really obsessed with your fucking power level.
You underestimate my power!
Well, maybe that was just some bullshit that the Emperor was telling him, you know? Oh, yes, your power will go up a whole bunch. Oh, yeah? What do I have to do?
All you have to do is touch my wiener.
Okay. Anyway, fucking Star Wars prequels, yeah. They kind of all fucking sucks. Yeah, all of them. They all fucking suck. They went the wrong fucking direction from the very fucking beginning, and they kind of fucked up the Star Wars mythology all over the fucking place. In so many different ways, it's just kind of sad. But they had fucking cool-ass toys. They did. Each of the fucking Star Wars movies had at least one fucking cool toy. The Darth Maul action figure was pretty cool. Jango Fett action figure was a really fucking cool figure, you know. And the General Grievous figure was really cool from Revenge of the Sith. You know, he had four arms. Yeah, that was a badass fucking toy. Yeah. You know. But that's the toys, you know. This is kind of what it's all about, you know. Even the new Force Awakens movie coming out, you know. Whether or not the movie's any good, at least we got those fucking toys, you know. Yeah. But, yeah. Anyway, till fucking next time, keep it fucking real. My weenie.
I don't know what to say.
Do it. Unnatural.